Alright, so this is a Stage 2 Harpies build. Right off the bat, you're going to notice that it is not running Oracle and running Karma Cut. And this was before Oracle actually released, when the KC Cup was going on. Oracle was not out in the event, which I believe was an event right after with Tag Duel. So this is the Stage 2 deck that I used to get to Stage 2. Stage 2 is pretty easy to get, so it wasn't that big of a feat, especially with Harpies being Tier 1. But I'm also going to go over a different build of this with Oracle that I got to King of Games with. So this is going to be like a Stage 2 KoG deck video. All the replays are going to be of Stage 2 in the KC Cup, or getting to Stage 2, because I forgot to save my rank up to King of Games duels. So that kind of sucked. I can go over them really quick, but it kind of defeats the purpose. There were a few meta decks and one disconnection, so that doesn't even really matter. There was Blue Eyes, Water Exceeds, Stardust, Synchro, Shenanigans, and Thunder Dragons, I think? I forget. So, but anyways, this is just this deck. You will notice I'm not running a few, probably what you might think are core cards, but I did get pretty good with this. I went to Stage 2, but I did not participate in the Stage 2 climb very much because I wasn't interested. I was just wanting to get actually to Stage 2. So anyways, get that out of the way. I'm playing my Harpy's Hunting Ground. Tie of Binds is probably better. That's what I played to get to King Games. But we're going to do Harpy's Hunting Ground for this. So, core of the deck, obviously. Three Channeler, one of your best openers you can have. One Harpist. In King Games, I don't use Harpist. I switch out one Harpist for two Oracle and some other stuff. I'll get to that. But in this, I was running one Harpist. She is nice, though. Three Perfumer, also core of the deck. You want to open with this or Channeler. Three Harpie Lady 1s, all prismatic. I like Harpie Lady 1s more than the other Harpie Ladies, and I'm not running Unexpected Die and the Vanilla Harpie Lady because I don't like that build at all. Two Forbidden Lance. If you have three Swallow's Nest, replace a Lance with Swallow's Nest. Replace this with Book of Moon if you have it. I don't have three Book of, I have one Book of Moon. So running two Lance and two Nest. I would have run three Nest, and I might use my Dream Ticket on it, but I have a feeling that if Harpies get nerfed in the next ban list, that Swallow's Nest may be a potential limit to two that they do originally to prevent them from running Treacherous and stuff, and I don't like running Treacherous in it anyways. One Hysteric Sign. It's pretty much a third Egotist. It's instead of running three Egotists by itself, I run one Hysteric Sign and two Egotists. So we got one Feathers Rest, the two Egotist, and two Karma Cut. Karma Cut is not a card that I don't use it anymore. I just don't suggest it's necessary. If you want to use Treacherous, go ahead. Before we have a limited to two Harpy card, but I don't personally like it. Book of Moon is obviously the best bet. You want to like set Book of Moon and summon Cyber Sloths on the first turn. They summon like maybe two monsters. You Book of Moon one, and then you pop it or return the other one back to the hand. So two Karma Cut. We got two Cyber Sloths Harpy Lady. Obviously, you don't want to run any more or any less. Utopia Ray with Utopia because you're probably gonna need it, to be honest. In this build, I was running Emeral. I stopped running Emeral. I use Abyss Dweller. Malevolent Sin, probably the best rank 4 we have in the game. And Thunder Spark Dragon to get rid of Lunalites and even Blue Eyes sometimes. Or even the Mirror Match, I like to do it. So that is the build for the KC Cup Stage 2. And I'm going to go to the replays in a second. I'm just going to show you what I got to King of Games with. So this is my King of Games deck. I like it a lot better. I'm going to go over it really, really quick because it's not really in the replays. It's just the last deck I just did. So the King of Games deck is one Sisters, two Oracle, three Chandler, three Perfumer, got rid of the Harpist, three Harpy Lady 1s, two Lance, two Nest, again, one Harpy's Underground, that is different, one Hysteric Sign, one Feathers Rest, and three Egotist instead of two because I'm running a Sisters now. And then two Hysteric Party, which is a big difference. So the main turn one, the reason why I'm running three Egotist and a Hysteric Sign, which may seem like a lot, is you want to open Channeler, somehow get Harpy Lady Sisters on the field through Egotist or Hysteric Sign if you can. Then you can use Channeler's effect, discard a card, get Perfumer, you can search two. And one of the reasons I'm running Harpy's Hunting Ground is because that can be one of the two that you search. So you could search, if you don't open Feathered Rest, you can get a Feathered Rest and another Egotist, or you can get Hunting Ground and Egotist, or Hunting Ground and Swallow's Nest. The extra deck is pretty much the same, except from running Abyss Dweller because of the new Shooting Star, Synchro Dragon, Abyss Dweller pretty much shuts that entire deck down. They can't do anything if you open up with an Abyss Dweller. So if you play against a Yusei and they're using the skill, which will activate before you can even do anything, or at least it'll show up and then put the card in the graveyard, you'll just open an Abyss Dweller. Not a big deal. One of the main things other than the opening turn being with Harpie Lady's Sisters is Hysteric Party. This card pretty much won me duels I shouldn't have won, and I definitely would not have won without it, obviously. I wish I could have saved them the videos, but I just forgot, and I didn't realize that if you didn't save them quick enough, they, like, just, you can't save them later, so, whoops. So you're gonna have to go with my Stage 2 deck. I don't want to make a whole new video for it, but I found a really fun, tech card to use in Harpies, if I can actually search it. Now, this card has some notoriousness in a TCG, and we only have one in Duel Links from Bandit Keith. But Smoke Grenade is a thief. So you can only run one, and I'd only run one. And if I would just add it to the deck. Maybe I would take out one of the Lances even. So what's good about Smoke Grenade is that if you're probably not going to open it because you're only running one. But if you draw into it, it's always a good card to draw into. You never go, I got thief. No, because the deck is so good as it is without any limits right now. You can Channeler and Perfumer are almost both one card synchros. So if you get either of them, or even an Oracle and a Swallow's Nest, or whatever you got, there's a lot of plays you can make. So what you do is you summon Cyber Lady, Cyber Slash Harpie Lady, off of your turn one, hopefully. Maybe you can Feather's Rest and then draw into it, or maybe you opened with it. You can activate it on if you're going to second, and then you can chain Harpie Harpie Lady, oh my god, I can't say her name, effect to the activation of this. And then you can return a card to the opponent's hand. And then, if you were able to summon Perfumer or draw two, grab two, whatever, you can get Hunting Ground. Hunting Ground, activate. You pop your own Thief. And if you don't know what Smoke Grenade of the Thief does, you look at your opponent's entire hand. That's what you want to do. You discard a card of your choice. It's not random, which is great, but you get to look at their entire hand. One of the biggest problems very soon to Harpies will be the new Weisel card, which just dropped the other day when I'm recording, and Weisel will be able to suck up your Cyber Slash Harpie Lady. Well, if you're able to go first and set up a play to use Smoke Grenade, you just discard the Weisel. Yeah, sure, they might be running three or four with the skill, but it's just fun, and then you can, like, discard your opponent's Book of Moon, discard your opponent's Cards of Consonance, one of their Onomats, the Thunder Dragons. I don't know if that might actually be helpful for Thunder Dragons, but the idea is to look at their hand, and you could discard their cover cut, and it's a lot of fun. I might make another deck profile and include that into some replays, because I really like how it works, and it's really funny, and nobody expects it. I forgot this card was even in Duel Links, but anyways, I hope you enjoy the rest of the video of the replays of Stage 2.
It's time to
Okay, so I lost all of my video to this project where I was recording my face and everything, so you're going to have to do without. I know you're all sad, but this is the automatic play deck. This is before the nerf, obviously. This is running in the KC Cup still, before the KC GT, which is going on right now. This was before, and then they did the banlist after, so at this point, you could return two cards to add the two automatic cards that you wanted, and Sister wasn't limited to two at the time. So you could play a bunch of Sisters and Hate Grenade and everything. So he's gonna summon Sister, get the Gigabolt. I have a pretty solid turn one, opening hand, where I have Channeler and Egotist and even a Karma Cut. When I was running Karma Cut, it actually was essential sometimes because you could make certain plays that you normally couldn't play make. But against Automats may not have been as important as maybe against a Blue Eyes, and which was pretty much the primary reason I was running Karma Cut. So he summons a Roach and a Bouncer. Now at this point, while playing Harpies, I was not 100% sure on what that could negate, because Roach is kind of confusing on its ruling with what an inherent summon is, especially when I didn't look into it. And then Bouncer's effect, I purposefully want to do right now, because I don't. So what I'm doing here is baiting out a negation so that when I summon Channeler next turn, unless I have to Karma Cut and use her, I could not get, negated, but I had a Lance and I was able to beat over him, so not a big deal. I get to use Malevolent Sin to banish the Roach, and I can summon Channeler. I have to get rid of Rest in order to summon another monster, but it's important enough of a play to make right now, especially against three back row. I don't know whether it could be to, you know, try to see if the Hourglass moves, see what the back row could be. I'm assuming that there's the two Gigabolts, and then I'm able to win, so it doesn't really matter what it is, I guess. But, yeah, that was Automat's full power back then. And then up next, we got Seto Kaiba running Ultimate Dragons. Blue Eyes White Dragon, personally, is the hardest matchup for Harpies as, I said personally already, but personally for me. And here we go, I've destroyed my own Hunting Ground again. I do believe the Hunting Ground is better to play in the deck than the skill, because most of the time you're just going to pop your own field spell and then it does nothing anyway, so what's the point? Might as well play Tie That Binds, or you could even play Beatdown if you really wanted to, something like that. I'm able to use Harpy's Feather to Rest, return the three cards back to my deck, draw two, get an Egotist, which is perfect, it's exactly what I wanted. I'm stumbling over every word that I say, that's okay. He just does like a L set, can't really do anything. What a terrible turn for Blue Eyes. So I get to go and attempt to return that card. He's going to Fiendish Chain my Cyber Slash, which negates it, but I still have an Egotist in my hand. So I go into Malevolent Sin. Malevolent Sin will let me banish whatever that card is. I attack into Sin, get counter-gated, and I can't attack with Slash because she's Fiendish Chained, obviously. So he's going to Econ take my Malevolent Sin. Now, if Malevolent Sin, so he banishes Cyber Slash and attacks into me, and he's going to go into, this is why I run Karma Cut, he's going to use 3, go overkill, and I'm going to Karma Cut whatever he does here. But with Sin banishing Cyber Slash, once Cyber Slash comes back to the field, is Fiendish Chain still on, like, equipped to her? I actually don't know, so if you can comment and let me know. I was unsure if I could even attack with her, but doesn't matter, I won. I'm just curious, I really don't know. So no, going up next, we're still running the Stage 2 deck. I honestly would like to know if I could have attacked with Fiendish Chain there, because I really didn't know. But I believe this is actually Stage 2 now, so you can see the background's a little different. Before, it was kind of like my tough matchups on the way to Stage 2 for the KC Cup. And remember, this is the KC Cup from April, not the KC GT going on right now. In June and May, popping my own field spell as normal to summon Channeler and Perfumer. Perfumer will search for Egotist. I have a Karma Cut and Rest, so Egotist is a good search in that point. I'll go into Cyber Slash Harpie Lady. Now with Cyber Slash Harpie Lady, I can use Feather Rest and draw two instead of drawing one, which is great. And if you don't remember, you have to remember you cannot summon anything other than Wind after using Feather Rest, which is one of the reasons I was using Daigusto Emeral, because you could summon him if you didn't have a second slash. So he's going to summon Channeler, I'm going to Karma Cut it, and then he surrenders, because if you disrupt a Harpy player turn one where they can't use Channeler or Perfumer, then you pretty much win. Even, I guess, in a mirror match. If he had a Egotist in his hand, he would have been able to Egotist off of my own Cyber Slash yet. I don't know if you know that. But if you are running the Harpy Mirror match, you can Egotist off of your opponent's Harpy Lady on the field. And it's a lot of fun to do that, because sometimes people don't realize that for whatever reason. Anyways, moving on, we got two Perfume and a Karma Cut. He's running a Blue Eyes deck without running Ultimate Dragon, so that's interesting. Pop my own field spell once again. Definitely don't run the skill, but I was kind of like doing the whole, you know, playing as mine with Harpies thing, and I liked that. So I'm going to Swallow his Mess, my Perfumer, after I was able to use the Surge off of her, go into Channeler. Channeler can discard Harpie Lady 1 and summon Harpist. Harpist will be able to search at the end of the turn if she stays in my graveyard. I'm going to use Feather Rest. Luckily, I can, because I use Swallow his Nest and Channeler on the same turn, I can keep Harpist in the graveyard so I can use Harpist Search at the end of the turn. So I return Maiden to get a Blue Eyes, and the only reason I do that, you normally wouldn't do that move, right? Except for I had a Karma Cut in my hand that I could just banish the Blue Eyes next turn, and if he normal summons, I'll chain Slash's effect. Here's a normal summon. You'll see me do it. I don't need to explain it. Gonna chain the effect, return the normal summon, so you can't do anything but special summon, and banish the Blue Eyes with the Karma Cut. So if you happen to have Karma Cut, maybe you don't have Lance, you might want to just not play Lance, play Karma Cut, but the discard is sometimes annoying, especially if you're going to run the Harpy Trap Hysteric Party. You don't want two discard cards, because you're not necessarily always going to have the ability to discard like every 2 seconds, unless you open optimally. But that was a decent, you know, showcase of defeating Blue Eyes, even though he wasn't running the optimal build of Blue Eyes. It was still in the KC Cup Stage 2, so Next up, we're going to go against Yusei. This is before Shooting Star came out. So when you saw Yusei, you didn't really 100% know what they were going to play. Nowadays, the skill will activate the Shooting Star skill, and you can just open up an Abyss Dweller, and then they can't do anything. So he's running Thunder Dragons. Dark will discard for Dark. And the Thunder Dragons are another deck that don't run back row, so Harpers Underground is going to pop itself again when I summon Perfumer. Search for Egotist. Didn't open a Channeler, but that's all right. Egotist into Harpie Lady 1. Those two cards will obviously would have made Cyber Slash, but I'm going to make Sin because I don't want to destroy whatever that face down is, if it's Aloof or if it's anything. I just didn't want to add it to the graveyard. It's a glow-up bulb, which I'm glad I didn't destroy because now he actually can't use the effect to mill, and then maybe he could have had extra effects in the graveyard. So, you know, it's good to not always just immediately go Harpy Harpy Cyber Slash. You got to think about... It's not hard to think about, but you gotta like think a little bit sometimes, you know, and not just do the same strategy over and over every turn you get, even though sometimes it looks like that. So I get to summon Harpist. I'm gonna Egotist with the Harpist on the field to summon Harpie Lady 1. Those two. This time I'll make Cyber Slash Harpie Lady. Now I can't be over the Force Focused, so what I want to do is draw two and hopefully draw the perfect card I need, and the perfect card I need is one of two things. Karma Cut, in this case, or I need a Forbidden Lance. I draw a Lance, I can reduce his light or his attack points to 2,000, and then I will Hysteric Sign, go into an Egotist. The Egotist will be for a follow-up, I will attack him Force Focus, and use Harpist in the end phase to add Channeler into my hand. I could have just Egotist into Harpie Lady 1, and potentially went for like a Lethal at that point, but... Tis what it is. If Force Focus negates a Harpie Lady Cyber Slash, I don't think her name counts as Harpie Lady, so you can't Egotist. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that was the problem and why I didn't go for Lethal at that point. I may be wrong, but I think it's what it was. And I was running only two Egotists in this deck, and the King Games version I do run three Egotists. That doesn't really make a huge difference, but I'm just, you know, letting you know. Just letting you know about that. Again, another again is that Harpie Lady Sisters is a pretty solid card to run in the deck if you're going to run a bunch of Egotists, because you can summon Channeler, Egotist, into Sisters, Channeler effect to Perfumer, and search two instead of just one. But as you can see, almost every duel I'm opening Perfumer instead of Channeler, so regardless, I wouldn't be able to do that play. But I'm going to pop Hunting Ground, as I think I have every single replay that I've showcase here so far. So I get to go into Cyber Slash Harpie Lady with the two Harpies on the field, and then I'm gonna set instead of use any effects, pretty much a bluff set, I believe. So he's running Evil Eye prior to nowadays, back when this was happening, was a little bit more frequent on the ladder, and I don't want to say more powerful, but it was sometimes a problem for Harpies, because if the Evil Eye player can get Selene equipped to Medusa, it kind of snowballs into a win for Evil Eye, unless you have Karma Cut, or, well, I don't think you can even target, right? So you couldn't even use Karma Cut, because you can't target with Cyber Slash's effect when they're equipped with a card. So he's going to chain a back row to my Egotist to destroy it. That's alright with me. That's fine. I'm going to summon Harpie Lady 1. He's going to activate Selene's effect. I'm going to chain to return to other monsters because I can't target the Medusa, even though it can special summon, whatever. I'm just returning a card from the field, getting rid of it. You know, I don't want it there right now. So I'm going to use a second Egotist. Got a second Harpie Lady 1 on the field. I got the other one in the graveyard, so my Egotists are all dead. I believe I used both of them. And I'm going to attack over, since it's at a lower attack point right now. I'm going to reduce his life point to as low as I can, because Selene requires a life point activation cost. I wanted to just reduce their life points as much as I can, because I can't target it, and I know it's going to use its effect, the Selene's effect, in the turn. So that goes negative 500 life points. He's going down to 300 right now. He's going to keep using all the different Evil Eye spells, and eventually, even if I return, it doesn't matter. He's going to go up to 6,500 attack, and then pay 500 life points and kill himself. So, you know, there was that. So now we're going to change to the King of Games deck. You can see the difference on the left side here, now that I got rid of my face. And then you can see my mat, that's from the Gladiator Beast event from like 3 years ago, I believe. I wish that event would come back. So this one is a little different. Obviously, I'm playing Oracle, got rid of Harpist, and I'm playing Hysteric Party and Sisters. I'm going to summon Channeler, go into Perfumer. I'm not popping my own field spell because I'm playing Tie That Binds with Jesse. Go into Cyber Slash. I can use Harpy Slither Rest to return all the cards I just used for that combo back to the deck and draw two. Hopefully I can draw a good card. If not, I can set lands. Perfect. Setting one card in Cyber Slash doesn't look like that much, but it's actually a very good turn one. And we're playing, what I wanted to showcase is Tri-Mints, because I have a really hard time playing against Tri-Mints. They are one of the harder decks for me personally to face, because you cannot get rid of Sphinx. Sphinx is gone, Sphinx is back. It's just a constant loop of that. You get rid of Sphinx, Sphinx is back. Even though they use non-stop spell cards, your Cyber Slash can only do it once per turn, but they're constantly changing, and you have to time it very right, and I just could never do that properly. So I'm going to attack into Hunter. Hunter's going to chain the, or not Hunter's going to chain, the Tri-Mint's going to chain their spell cards, field spells. He's going to search for another Hunter on the attack, and then he's going to use Tri-Mint Pulse on that, pop my Cyber Slash Harpy Lady, which is a problem. I destroy the monster. There's Sphinx, like I was talking about. He's going to summon Hunter, summon another, I can't even tell if that's another Hunter, it's not. He's going to use Kingdom. Kingdom, I believe, is the one that makes me not be able to activate any spell traps or effects during a battle phase, which is a problem, obviously. I get to summon Channeler, pop the Pulse, but Pulse will chain the effect to pop my Channeler. Luckily, I can chain my Lance to protect my Channeler from being popped. That's one of the reasons the Lance is super important to this deck. I'm going to attempt to activate Channeler's effect, but he's going to chain some of the Tri-Mid cards to the effect activation, but because I'm Lance, I don't really care. I didn't even need to read them. Pop the face down. Perfumer will also chain to that to search. So certain, it's almost a chain block. When you're playing the mirror match, Perfumer will chain block the field spell for the opponent slash to activate, just so you know. Anyways, he's gonna chain the Tri-Mid card to my field spell because I'm trying to pop the field spell. And then he chains to protect it from being popped, sort of. It goes in the graveyard anyways, but whatever. I try to get rid of Sphinx. It's kind of not going to do much, but Sphinx is off the field at this moment, which is important enough for me. I'm going to Egotist into Harpie Lady 1. Try to pop the other field spell. It is popped. He can't do anything about it. But because it's popped, Sphinx is right back. 4,000 attack. That's a problem. I Egotist into another Harpie Lady 1. Now I have to pop my own field spell. That's okay. I'll survive. I'm going to Disease into Utopia because I have 50 life points left after the last turn. And then I get to go into Utopia Ray, and this is one of the primary reasons I run this. Even though you never see me use it, this is the one time where I need to, because I have no other option to get rid of Sphinx. Attack that binds into Sphinx, 3,200, and I barely scrape by with 50 life points left against Tri-Mids. I thought that was really awesome. I had to include that. I'm sure most of you haven't watched this far, and I'm talking to myself, but that's awesome. That's okay, I don't mind. Here I'm running Primo, Mr. Primo himself, in a mirror match, and I, for a while, in Legend, yeah, this is Legend, this is before King Games, on the Legend grind, I was running Vampire Vamp as a tech card for matches like the mirror match, and for matches like Blue Eyes White Dragon, because it is really funny to get, and you're able to swarm the field pretty frequently with Harpies, so I thought that Vampire Vamp with two tributes to summon is alright. So luckily I get to go into a pretty full board, but I'm going to avoid using spells because of his Cyber Slash, and I go into Sparky Thunder Dragon Dude, destroy everybody, but you know, Harpies are really good at just constantly being able to do their combo, so he's going to do pretty much the exact same combo as I was able to do. Go into a Cyber Slash and a Harpy Lady 1 and Feather Rest to return my Thunder Spark Dragon back to my hand and return 3 cards from his graveyard back to his hand, draw 2. Very strong combo, obviously, you can see that. Egotist into another monster, that is full on lethal, Tie That Binds, 2200, but Hysteric Party, best card in the deck, brings all my cards back on the field. I take the 22, but that's okay, all you can do is destroy up to 2 Harpies since it's battle phase, you can't really do anything else. I have one Harpy Lady on the field, but I have an Egotist in my hand, which is perfect. So I'm going to Egotist into my other Harpy Lady 1, and then I can go into Vampire Vamp, suck up Cyber Slash, no spell activation, 4,600 attack right to his face over the Harpy Lady 1, and kill him. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed. Peace out.